There are many ways to speed up Cycle's renders in Blender. You can optimize scene geometry, lower max light path bounces, or just reduce the total number of lights. Then there's the classic solution of just buying faster hardware or renting it via render farms, but that can get costly very fast. Another option is add-ons, which fall into two main categories. Those that recode parts of a default Cycle's engine and work as a total replacement, such as K-Cycles or E-Cycles, or others such as Turbo Tools, which is what we are going to look at today, that use standard Blender with fancy denoise code to render better images using lower samples. Now, none of these add-ons are free, but if they do the job, they are at least way cheaper than a hardware upgrade. So let's see how Turbo Tools performs. After making a few changes to the standard BMW file, like increased resolution output and using denoising, we end up with a standard render time of around 27 seconds. Turning on Turbo Render and adjusting a few options to suit the scene we are rendering, the render time is now just over 10 seconds using the high presets for both samples and denoising. So almost three times faster, but how does the quality compare? On the surface, they look pretty much the same. Zooming in on the bonnet, and the Turbo Render has a cleaner line with less noise. Taking a closer look at the headlight, and both are similar with overall brightness and sharpness of details. There is a little difference in the denoise pattern inside the headlight, but it's mostly just different rather than better or worse. Now, it is possible to lower the samples and denoising presets to medium on Turbo Render for even faster output. However, while it still looks good overall, if we focus again on the headlight, there is now clearly a loss of detail. So while faster presets could be used for quick tests and preview renders, a higher setting is needed for final images. There is another option we can test, and that is CPU rendering. While the BMW scene will render on just about any GPU, it still makes for an interesting comparison if you happen to have a scene that doesn't fit in the GPU's VRAM. On changing the device to CPU and turning on noise threshold, standard Blender takes 198 seconds to render. Enabling Turbo Render with the same settings used for the previous GPU output, and now the CPU only takes 68 seconds. So again, around three times faster, and on comparing the results, it is of course no different to the previous high quality GPU renders. Let's have a look at the Barcelona scene and see if we can get the same results. Setting output to full HD and turning on denoising, standard Blender takes 39 seconds to render. Using the same high quality presets as before, and this time Turbo Render gets the job done in just 10 seconds. Comparing the two renders, and overall there is little difference. On closer inspection, we can see that there is sharper details in the textures, along with a minor difference in the denoise pattern. So once again, we end up with the same or better quality render, only this time Turbo Render is four times faster. Not everything works out as well. The splash screen for Blender 2.92 is only around 14 seconds faster with Turbo Render, while the results are a little different. Overall, both seem fine, but there are a few areas where we have distinct differences. In the top left corner, we have clear details with the standard render, while Turbo Render is blurred out. It can of course be argued that the more distant out of focus area should be blurry. Likewise, the legs have more texture detail, making Turbo Render better in both cases. However, standard Blender has both better details in the edge fur on the creatures, along with less noise in the bokeh dots. To be fair, while the total render time isn't a lot faster, at least the first 30 seconds is scene prep and setup, using at times 100% of the CPU. This is the same for both the standard render and Turbo Render. As such, the actual part that Turbo Render does is in fact a fair bit faster. So the longer the actual rendering part takes, be it on the GPU or the CPU for large scenes that don't fit in VRAM, then the more time you can save with Turbo Render. On the other hand, if all your renders currently complete in about a minute or less, then it's likely not worth the time to do a few test renders to dial in the settings for Turbo Render. So while Turbo Tools can significantly decrease render times, like anything, it can depend on your exact use cases as to how big an advantage it will make. If you want to see more or have specific questions or requests, then please click the usual YouTube buttons and or leave a comment below. If not, that's perfectly fine, and I hope to see you for the next one. Cheers.